Hello, I'm Linda Gray-Martin, Vice President of RSA Conference, and welcome to today's Know Before You Go webcast for RSAC 2022. We're only a couple of weeks away now, and we are also genuinely excited at the thought of bringing the community together once again in San Francisco. So today's webcast is really going to give you an overview of what you can expect when you get to RSA Conference, and we're going to be offering you some helpful hints as well to help shape your experience. Whether you've attended multiple times before or this is going to be your first time, it's always good to come with a plan. I'm joined by several of my colleagues today, so please use the Q&A feature to submit your questions at any time, and we'll be answering them throughout the webcast. We're also going to make the recording of this session and the slides available on the RSA Conference website if you'd like to reference it again. So here's a look at what we're going to be covering, from this year's theme to what to look for after the conference, because there are still many more learning opportunities that are going to be coming your way year round. I'm especially excited about this year's theme, Transform, because as a community, we've transformed, and as individuals, we have too. As Haruki Murakami says, when you come out of the storm, you won't be the same person who walked in. That's what this storm's all about, and never a truer word has been spoken. Professionally, we've moved from behind the scenes professionals to business enablers entrusted with game-changing decisions. The spotlight is on us as an industry, and as the world becomes more digitized, people are looking to us for protection and response. Let's continue to grow, evolve, and join forces to enable everyone everywhere to be able to connect securely and confidently, because together we transform. And with that, I'm going to turn it over to Michelle Adams-Dixon, who's going to walk us through the health and safety information for the conference this year. Thank you.
Hello, everyone. My name is Michelle Adams-Dixon, and I'm going to be speaking about the health and safety for RSA Conference 2022. So this is the first time that we will be together in a few years, and our community's well-being is incredibly important to us. So we wanted to walk through the health and safety measures that will be taking place at the Moscone in June. We are continuously monitoring the state of the pandemic, working with the city of San Francisco and reviewing their health order. And over the course of the last few months, we've been adjusting our health protocols as needed for all of our attendees, exhibitors, and staff. On our website, we have a health and safety hub, which is the place that everybody should be going to prior to conference and week of conference to see what the latest and greatest updates are. The Moscone Center itself has been awarded the Global BioRisk Advisory Council GBAC star accreditation. What that really means is that they have worked very closely with various parties to ensure that the safety and sanitization of the Moscone Center is meeting a high level of standards. The Moscone Center has also optimized their HVAC systems to provide maximum number of air exchanges per hour. So that is also a critical point for you to know. The other key point is we want to ensure that the community at conference is feeling healthy. And if you're not, please stay home. We do have a digital pass and you'll be able to experience the sessions online. When you're attending RSA conference this year, the COVID-19 vaccination process is in place, where we will need to verify that you have had your complete initial series of testing or a proof of a negative COVID-19 test. For individuals who have not received the complete initial series of a COVID-19 vaccination, the negative COVID-19 test will need to be taken within 24 hours if it's an antigen test, or 48 hours for a PCR or molecular form of testing. And these need to be taken prior to entrance of the event. A self-administered antigen test is acceptable if there is third-party verification. All these details are highlighted on our website, which is the Health and Safety Hub at rsaconference.com. So when you get to RSA Conference, the verification needs to happen prior to picking up your pass at the Moscone South. You do have two options for validation. The first option is digital, and that is utilizing the Safe Spaces member app. This particular app also accepts international vaccine cards as well as cards from the United States. And the second option is if you do not want to digitally upload your card, we will have representatives on site in Moscone North prior to picking up your badge. So if you are not going to be uploading your badge, please go to Moscone North Upper Lobby and there will be directions for you there. If you're using the app, we recommend that you upload your information prior to attending the conference. And for forms of documentation, please feel free to use your vaccination card, either as a picture, a photocopy, or a hard copy. As long as it's clear and visually shows the dates of the vaccination along with your name, that will be all that you need. Again, please visit our health and safety hub for additional details. Thank you. Over to Amy Hubbard to talk about the essentials for RSA Conference 2022.
Thank you, Michelle. My name is Amy Hubbard and I manage the day-to-day operations for RSA Conference. And today I'm going to be covering the essentials and everything that you need to know for the week of RSA Conference. So I'm going to start by covering our RSA Conference campus, just to give you the lay of the land so that you can see where different activities are taking place. So at a high level, we have our three main campus buildings, Moscone North, Moscone South, and Moscone West. You'll see that Moscone North and South are directly across from each other, and they're actually connected in two different locations. The first being the Sky Bridge on level two, and the second being in the lower levels between North and South Expo, which you can see in this diagram below. When you come out of Moscone North and South, you'll see that Moscone West is just a short walk down Howard Street. And in between the two locations, we have different sponsored activities. So when you're making the trek down to Moscone West, you'll definitely want to be sure to stop and check those out. And I'll go into more detail about those sponsored activities in a later slide. So now that you see how the different buildings connect, we're going to start and dive in deeper with Moscone South. I'll run through at a high level what's taking place in each one of these buildings. And then as we go through the presentation, Casey and I will be diving into deeper detail about the different locations and the content in each area. So don't worry, you won't be missing any important information. So when you arrive to RSA Conference, you're going to want to go to registration, which is at the street level of Moscone South. On this level, when you enter into the lobby, you'll see registration for your badge pickup and registration for those of you who haven't registered yet. You'll also, once you've picked up your badge materials, you'll also want to head over to material pickup for those of you who are full conference badge attendees. In this space, we also have an info desk set up and a coat and bag check. So if you go up the escalators to the next level, which is the South Esplanade, you'll see our RSAC bookstore. Behind that, you'll see our press working rooms and press meeting rooms. And as you make your way down the hallway, you'll head into the next area, which on Monday afternoon will be the RSAC Innovation Sandbox Contest. And then on Tuesday, it flips over to the South Stage Keynotes, which will be taking place on Tuesday through Thursday. Heading up to the next upper levels of South, starting on South Level 2, you'll see on Tuesday, we have the FIDO Alliance Seminar taking place. Our partner perceptive tracks sessions will be taking place in this space as well. And then on Tuesday and Thursday, our early stage expo and sandbox will be taking place. And then as you head up to level three, you'll see that there's a lot going on throughout the week. So we'll start on Sunday and Monday. We have trainings taking place as well as a CSA Trust Summit. You'll see throughout the week, the prayer room is located in South 311, and that is one room that stays consistent throughout the week. Then on Tuesday on South Level 3, we have our women's networking reception, the inclusive security track sessions, and then the DevOps Connect. And then on Wednesday on South Level 3, the space then converts to the EWF meet and greet, the FAIR seminar, and the IAPP seminar. Now heading down to Moscone South Lower Level, this puts you in our South Expo space. I'll go into more detail about the Expo space later in this presentation, but I wanted to cover at a high level just how the two buildings connect using this space. So starting in the South Expo space, you'll see that there's a connector that connects the North and South buildings. So you can head over to the North Expo space, and then from there, you can head up the escalators, which puts you in the North Upper Lobby. And this is where on-site COVID-19 vaccine and negative test verification location is. You'll only need to go to this location if you haven't pre-verified ahead of conference. Okay, so exiting Moscone North and South and heading down the street to Moscone West. Entering in at the street level, in the lobby, you will see an info desk, broadcast alley, and coat check. This is also where our South Stage keynotes will be taking place, which will start on Monday afternoon this year. Heading up to the upper levels of Moscone West, on West Level 2 in the lobby area, you'll see our Loyalty Plus Lounge, our Cyru Cafe, and there'll be a bunch of common seating area for those of you looking for a place to just sit down and catch up on work, you know, maybe meet and greet different attendees, and just space for you to use. It's also where our session viewing point will be, our speaker office and lounge, the mother pods, and our birds of a feather sessions. We'll also have track sessions in this area as well. And heading up to West Level 3, you'll see that this is where all of the track sessions will be taking place. So now that you have the lay of the land, let's jump into some of the logistical details that you'll need to plan out before you get to conference. So when you arrive to RSA conference, you're going to want to head to Moscone South, where I pointed out the registration area is. You'll see on the slide here the registration and check-in schedule. This year, RSA conference starts on Monday with content running in the morning and keynotes starting in the afternoon, and will conclude Thursday afternoon with our closing keynote. Therefore, registration is opening from Saturday and will run through Thursday, and you can see the specific times per day noted here. One of our pro tips is that we do see it extra busy on Monday and Tuesday. So we do recommend that if you're coming in early, that you make some time to go before you start attending your sessions. It is busy, so we want to make sure that you have enough time to go through the registration process and get the materials you need before heading to your first session. You do need a valid government issued ID when you pick up your materials. And this year, all attendees are required to check themselves in. So you won't be able to pick up a pass for someone else. And this is just to verify that everyone has gone through the verification process for the COVID-19 and the negative tests. So I'd also like to point out that before you arrive, you'll receive an email from us with a QR code. You'll want to bring that up on your phone and have that handy when you check into registration. That will ensure a smooth and easy process of checking in. One other thing to note is that bags are subject to change, and we've noted here that bags larger than 16 by 22 by 9 are not permitted, but we do have a bag check, which we've noted in the floor plans, and I'll talk about a little bit later in the slides. Something else that's new this year is that there is no download necessary for our mobile experience. So for the best experience when browsing RSAC 2022, you want to visit the URL noted here, rsaconference.com/mobile4. This is where you can view the agenda, explore sessions, and get room locations. You'll also be able to build your personal schedule and reserve a seat for those sessions that you absolutely want to attend. You'll also see daily featured programs listed here and also have access to those campus maps that we reviewed at the beginning of this presentation. You'll also be able to provide feedback on the sessions that you've attended through the surveys. This is definitely something that you will want to have pulled up and ready to go, as it will make your experience throughout the week a lot smoother. So if you're anyone like me, I know when I'm attending a big conference with days full of meetings and sessions that I want to attend, I'm always thinking about where I'm going to get my next meal and how I'm going to stay fueled for the day. So I quickly want to run through what our food options are. For full pass conference holders, you will be served a continental breakfast Monday through Thursday. The locations and times are noted here on the slide. We also have our Cybrew Cafe, which is a full service coffee bar, which is opened Monday through Thursday, 7:30 a.m. to 2:30 p.m. on West Level 2. This is free for all full conference pass holders. We also have paid food options available through concession stands located in Moscone North, South, and West. Moscone is a now cashless facility, but they do accept all major debit cards and credit cards. And of course, there's always off-campus meals that you can look up through different apps. There's tons of locations near the Moscone Center, as well as in the Metreon that we highly recommend checking out. And for those of you who are staying at official RSAC hotels, we do provide shuttles to and from the Moscone Center. During the prime peak hours, they run every 15 minutes and then every 30 minutes midday service. You'll see the schedule outlined here on the slide, but if you go to the website, there's more information. You can look up which hotel you're staying at and get the exact route and pickup times. And for those of you who are staying closer to Moscone and there is no shuttle service, we are doing our Safe Walk program again this year. So working in conjunction with San Francisco Travel and local officials to increase patrols to ensure a safe walk to and from Moscone. Some additional transportation options. If you're going to be using a rideshare location, the pickup location is 800 Howard Street, which is right in front of Moscone West. Your Uber or Lyft driver will have this information, but it's always good to know ahead of time that they'll be dropping you off right in front of West. There's also parking garages for those of you who will be driving in. You'll want to use the Spot Hero app to reserve your spot ahead of time and use our promo card code RSAC2022 to get $5 off your reservation. Again, check out our venue and travel page and Getting Here tab to see more information on transportation to plan out how you're going to get to and from the Moscone Center. And next, as I mentioned in the floor plans and in the last slides, that we do have coat and bag checks. They're available Monday through Thursday, located in North, South, and West. The times do vary by day, so you'll want to check your mobile experience as well as your program guide to look those dates or times up. You want to keep in mind it is first come, first serve, and we do see a high volume towards the end of the week, so you'll want to plan accordingly. And the last thing I want to cover before I hand it over to Casey to cover content is our social media channels. We are very active on our social media channels during the week of conference. We have a lot planned, including live video interviews on LinkedIn and just in live time updates that we'll be providing. You'll want to be sure to be following us on social media as well as our hashtag RSAC. And now I'll hand it over to Casey to cover content.
Thanks, Amy. As she mentioned, I'm Casey Zirkus, content strategist for the RSA Conference team, and I'm super excited to talk to you about the learning opportunities that will be available at RSA Conference 2022. And we have 24 topics and tracks. Across all of those, we will have more than 550 speakers who will be delivering more than 350 sessions, including more than 25 keynotes across both the Moscone West and South stages. So lots of super exciting content to be delivered through traditional sessions, interactive sessions, trainings and seminars from our industry associations. Plus we have the RSAC sandbox, lots of hands-on activity, all of which, or most of which, is available for CE credits and will be available on demand 24 hours after the live show. So a lot of opportunities for you to advance your understanding of the different challenges you are facing in your jobs right now. So here's a look at the topics and tracks that will be available at RSA Conference 2022. Most of them are familiar to you if you've visited us before, but I do want to call out one that is completely new this year, which is Zero Trust, probably not a surprise to anyone. And we have also modified a couple of titles to be sort of more inclusive of the broader umbrella of this category. So you'll see cloud security has evolved into cloud security and cloud SecOps, and DevSecOps has evolved into DevSecOps and software integrity. We've also evolved protecting data to include protecting data and the supply chain. So we try and stay current with the changes that are happening and reflect those changes in our topics and tracks every year. So when you go to rsaconference.com, you can click on the event and then look at the full agenda. And we have a variety of different ways that you can filter through the agenda. So choose what works for you. When I go in, I'm usually looking for the BOFs or the learning labs. So I go through and I filter by type and format, and I click on BOF or learning lab. But you can explore by track, you can explore by subtopic, you can explore by day of the week, even by the classification, whether it's general, intermediate, or advanced. So you can filter through exactly what you're looking for so that you see what you are after. You can also then both favorite and reserve a seat for these sessions that you like. But you want to make sure that if you absolutely must see a session, that you do click on the reserve a seat button, because tagging it as a favorite session is not the same as reserving your spot there. So if you don't want to miss it, you want to make sure you reserve a seat. You do not need to reserve a seat if you want to watch it on demand. That's not a problem. But please know that there are some limitations to the reserve a seat. The line does open 20 minutes before the session begins, and it closes 5 minutes before the session starts. So if you have yet to claim your seat by that 5 minute limit, your seat will be released and open to anyone who's waiting online. So for if you'd like additional information, you can go ahead and explore our website at www.rsaconference.com/seats. You also have the ability to create your own schedule. If you click on My Schedule, you can choose the sessions that you want to attend by reserving your seat, and you'll have just your single schedule that you can view. And you can visit www.rsaconference.com/USA/agenda/full agenda, go through the filters, and then add your reserve a seat, and then verify that all of those seats that you want to make yours are actually there in your schedule by clicking on My Schedule. So we also, as Amy mentioned, have the keynotes going on in both West and South. And we have morning keynotes on Monday that are open to full conference attendees. Those will be in Moscone West. I recommend strongly that you get there early, because as you can see in the photo, it is a full packed room. So we want to make sure that we're able to get started on time and that you're able to get a seat and enjoy the conversations that are happening on the stage. So please do allow enough time in your schedule to get there early. South Stage keynotes are open to full conference and Expo Plus pass holders only. So please be aware of the type of pass that you have. You can totally upgrade to a different pass if you're interested in seeing keynotes, and know what restrictions there might be associated with your pass. You can also watch the keynotes in our alternate viewing area in Moscone West, level 3. And they are also available on live stream at www.rsaconference.com. There are also session points to view any sessions that might be full. So maybe you favorited something instead of reserving a seat. Oops, it happens, right? So you wait in line and you can decide, do you want to stay in this line or do you just want to go into the session viewing point and watch it on live stream, which totally works as well. So in this room, there are 4 different sessions that are going on. We'll provide you with headphones so you can listen along and watch the one big screen of the session that you were hoping to attend. These are open Monday through Thursday while the track sessions are in progress. And that is in Moscone West, level 2, room 2004. This is open to full conference attendees. As Amy also mentioned, we have our association seminars. We're super excited to bring these back this year. They are taking place Monday through Wednesday. The times do vary, so be sure and check the schedule on that full agenda. And know that there are a variety of different topics being covered in Moscone South, rooms 302, 303, and 216. All pass types are invited to attend. There are also trainings, which are led by our industry association's FAIR Institute and ISC Squared. These are two-day, hands-on, very interactive, and they're on a variety of different topics, running Sunday through Monday in Moscone South Level 3. So these are also made available CE credits. They are open to full conference pass, Expo Plus Pass, and Expo Pass holders. Important to note here that the trainings are an additional cost and they can be added to your registration portal, but space is limited. So you definitely want to make sure that you register for those if you're interested. Also available at limited capacity are our learning labs. So the interactive and collaborative learning opportunities are in high demand because they are interactive and you're able to learn along with, in, through, and from other members of the community. So obviously we need to limit the space in order to make that a great experience for everyone. So please do look through the learning labs when you filter the agenda and identify the ones that you wish to attend. And you can reserve your seat for those. Make sure that you are a full conference pass holder. Press is not permitted. And again, I want to stress that space is limited. So please be sure to reserve your seat because these are great learning opportunities and we don't want you to miss out. We also have the RSAC Innovation Sandbox Contest on Monday, June 6th, and that will run from noon to 3 p.m. at the Esplanade in Moscone South. And here you will see the 2022 top 10 finalists, and they will be giving their 3-minute pitch demonstrating what is their innovative groundbreaking solution to the RSA conference community. This is open to all conference pass holders and Expo Plus pass holders. And finally, the RSAC conference. I said finally, but I don't actually think this is my final slide, so I'm going to take that back. RSAC Sandbox is a full hands-on interactive experience, and you can engage with others and explore six different sandboxes and also engage in some capture the flag opportunities. That's located in Moscone South, level 2. It is open to full conference pass and Expo Plus pass holders. And you can see here the days and times, Tuesday, Wednesday, and Thursday, that will be available. We also have, very exciting this year, the Inclusive Security Agenda. And this is an evolution of what was formerly our She Speaks Security series. And we here highlight and include sessions from underrepresented parts of our community. So super excited to be able to bring these amazing speakers to our agenda, which will be located at Moscone South Level 3. It is open to all pass holders who are on site, and we have some great sessions with incredible influencers in the industry. So definitely take the time to check out that agenda and get to some of those sessions if you're able to. And then finally, we have the RSAC Advanced U opportunity, which provides outreach to college students to encourage a career in information security. And it also supports education through the various stages of a career within the industry. RSAC Advanced U includes Security Scholars, RSAC Scholars College Day, and continuing education credits. So I think one more. The CE credits are available through FAIR Institute, GIAC, IAPP, ISACA, and ISC Squared. The credits do vary based on your organization and association, so make sure that you know what their requirements are, and you could submit details through rsaconference.com/CE-credits to learn more. And that is it for me, and I will hand it back to Amy for some networking activities and special events that you should know about.
So now that we've covered all of the logistical details and all of your content opportunities throughout the week, let's get to the fun stuff. If you've attended RSA Conference in the past, you know there are tons of networking opportunities and special events throughout the week. So I'm going to start by reviewing a couple of our events that we have going on this week. We kick off our special events with the welcome reception on Monday, June 6th. This takes place from 5 p.m. to 7 p.m. This is the kickoff of the North and South Expo space as well. So this is your first opportunity to get in to see those vendors and exhibitors that you were planning to meet. It's also a great opportunity to network with your peers and attend and enjoy some food and drink while doing so. This event is open to all pass types. Moving on to events that are taking place on Tuesday, we have our Cyber Ops event, which is from 4:45 p.m. to 6 p.m. This is located in the Early Stage Expo in Sandbox area in Moscone South Level 2. This is a great opportunity to get into those spaces, enjoy local California craft beers and other non-alcoholic drinks, along with some really tasty snacks. This event is open to all attendees that are over the age of 21, and it's open to full conference pass holders, Expo Plus pass holders, and press pass holders. Also taking place on Tuesday is one of my favorite networking events, which is our RSAC Women's Networking Reception. This is a great opportunity to celebrate the women in our cybersecurity community and network with peers. This event takes place from 4:45 to 7 p.m. It's located in Moscone South, Level 3 in room 307. This event is also open to all pass holders. And on Wednesday, we have our Expo Pub Crawl. This takes place from 4:30 p.m. to 6 p.m. and it's located in your North and South Expo areas. It's another great opportunity to get into those spaces and meet with the exhibitors and sponsors that are on your list. You'll want to refer to your Expo guide for the map of participating companies. We'll also have visuals so that you can see who's participating when you're in those spaces. This is open to all pass types as well. So now I'd like to highlight some of our special programs that we have going on this year. Once again, we have our Broadcast Alley, which is the unofficial newsroom of RSAC. This is located in Moscone West in the street level in the lobby area. So as you're going to the West Stage keynotes or going to track sessions in West, you'll want to be sure to stop by this location to see the top security publications recording live exclusive interviews with cybersecurity VIPs. This is open Monday through Thursday, and the times that it's open are highlighted here on the slide. So one of the things that I know myself and the entire RSA Conference team are most excited about this year is that we partnered with Team Rubicon, which is a veteran-led disaster response organization. They have more than 150 volunteers that help people prepare, respond to, and recover from disasters and humanitarian crises. We're really excited to be partnering with them this year, and you'll see different promotions for them throughout the week. You'll definitely want to check out Jake Wood's keynote on Wednesday afternoon, but they'll also have a presence in our North Expo in booth 4610. Their team will be on site for you to meet, learn how to volunteer, and more. Team Rubicon also created a private page for us where we can donate to their cause. We're really excited for this and to see how our attendees, sponsors, exhibitors, and staff participate with them throughout the week. So check out the link and donate if you can. So I talked a little bit earlier while we were reviewing the campus about our sponsored experiences. We have a ton of them this year, and I really think that it's going to enhance the attendee experience. So you'll see the two that were noted, those are on the street, on Howard Street, as you're walking between Moscone West and Moscone North and South. The others are located in the expo floor. You'll definitely want to check these out, and I'll review the whole expo floor and point out where they're all located when we review that floor plan. The next thing I wanted to talk about is our RSAC Loyalty Plus program. This is a benefits program for the people who've attended 5 or more conferences as full pass conference holders. Members get an exclusive perks throughout the year, discounts, special check-in counters, the lounge that I pointed out in Moscone West that has snacks and drinks, and a few other perks. We do want to ensure that if you are Loyalty Plus, that you are getting the credit you deserve. So when you're registering, you want to be sure to know if your email has changed, as that's the way that we track our Loyalty Plus program. The last thing I want to cover for programs is our bookstore and cybersecurity canon. Digital Guru brings you the latest cybersecurity titles, special discounted rates. This is located in Moscone South on the Esplanade level. There will be different book signings throughout the week, and you'll also receive 20% off all of your purchases. And new this year, you're going to want to check out the Cybersecurity Canon 2022 Hall of Fame winners. This is a curated list of cybersecurity books that was created to help cybersecurity professionals find meaningful information and resources. You'll definitely want to check them out in the bookstore 2 to 3 p.m. every day. You can also go online to our website and check out the online bookstore as well. And then you'll also see noted on this slide the hours and days that the bookstore is open. So next, I'm going to cover some information about the Expo. This year, we have over 400 exhibitors across one continuous floor plan. So as you saw in the floor plan, how North and South are connected via the connector, and we have booths along the entire space. This also includes two briefing centers, one in the North Expo space and one in the South Expo space. This is space for 20 to 30 minute technical demos from our exhibitors, and that is open to all pass types. You'll notice here on the bottom of the screen the dates and times that the Expo is open. So taking a look at the high level plan, I'll dive into each location in a little bit, but I did want to show the entire plan again. And I will talk about Marketplace in a couple more slides as well in more detail, but it is a great way for you to filter and find your exhibitors. You can filter by product and solution, and it's a great tool when you're planning out your Expo visit. We do know that the floor can be overwhelming at times. There are a ton of vendors, and you want to ensure that you hit all of the ones that you want to. So it's a great tool to use when planning. So taking a closer look at the North Expo floor, you can see the booths laid out here, and then you'll see the activation spaces that I mentioned on the previous slide are highlighted here in yellow. All of these floor plans, again, will be in the mobile experience, and they'll also be in your program guide so that it's easy to identify. And then you'll also see in the right corner, the North Expo Briefing Center. And moving over to the South Expo floor plan, you can see the same thing. You see the South Expo Briefing Center highlighted in purple, and then those sponsor activation zones highlighted in yellow. And then you'll also see to the left, we have our RSAC Security Operations Center, which I'll touch on in a few more slides. So I also want to talk about our RSAC Early Stage Expo. This is located in Moscone South Level 2 in the Sandbox area. You'll see the agenda to the right with the dates and times that the space is open. This year we have 35 emerging cybersecurity startups that are there to demonstrate their products and solutions. You'll want to take the time to sit down on the demos to see of these companies as well. These take place on Wednesday and Thursday. This space is open to full conference pass and Expo Plus pass holders on Tuesdays. And starting on Wednesday, it's open to everybody. And I just wanted to quickly highlight the Early Stage Expo floor plan that you see here. Again, this will be in all of your conference materials when you arrive on site. One other thing we want to highlight in the Expo space is our international pavilions. This year we have 5 country pavilions, which represent 60 different companies. We've highlighted them all here with their booth numbers and their links to more information. And once again this year, we have our RSAC Security Operations Center. This is a great time to take a tour of a working SOC to see what's really taking place on the Moscone Wireless Network in real time. It's located on Moscone South Expo, where I just pointed out, and it's open during Expo hours. You can visit the Cisco and RSA booths for more information on touring. They also do a session on Thursday, which will take place from 1 p.m. to 1:50, and this is a readout report of their findings through the week. This is a don't miss session, and we highly recommend attending. And the last thing I want to cover in the Expo section is your perks pack. As a full conference holder, you'll receive your perks pack in your conference bag when you pick up your materials during registration. This includes sponsored giveaways, drawings, and more. You'll want to take your booklet, take a look before you enter into the expo, and go to those sponsor booths to redeem your prizes and other conference perks. So I know we've given you a ton of information. So now I want to go through a couple tips and tricks and how you can use this information to plan your week so that you have a successful RSA conference. So let's start off. Pack for comfort and convenience. The attire is business casual clothing, but we highly recommend wearing comfortable shoes. As you saw, there is a lot of space to cover between all of the expo space and going between all of the Moscone buildings. There are also long days. I'm sure you'll be going from meeting to session, so don't forget to pack your battery phone charger. And again, check the weather just to be sure of what's to come for the day. And as Casey mentioned, we highly recommend planning ahead. You're going to want to schedule those meetings early in the week and schedule them ahead of time before arriving to RSA conference. We have tons of networking spaces for you to use in Moscone Level 2 and the alcoves 1 and 2 that I pointed out when we reviewed our floor plans. As Casey mentioned, you're also going to want to schedule and reserve your seats. Sessions fill up quickly, so we highly recommend that you do that. And always have a backup plan. There's a lot going on and sessions fill up quickly. So maybe have a couple sessions that you want have in the back of your mind that if you don't make it to your first, you can go into those instead. And don't stress, if you miss something or you're double booked, you can always catch it on demand. You also want to take care of yourself. As you saw, it's a lot of distance to cover. You don't want to burn yourself all out on Monday. You want to conserve your energy and make it through the week. So going into it with a full plan of the week is highly recommended. And be smart about the expo space. As I mentioned, there are tools to use. Marketplace is a great place to start to lay out which companies you want to see. Also, I do want to note that the nearest business center is the FedEx office, which is located at the Marriott Marquis on B2, which is the Golden Gate level. I also want to highlight that rsaconference.com is the only legitimate website for RSA Conference and that we do not sell attendee information to third-party data aggregators. This is something we take seriously, so if you do receive an email like this, please send it to information@rsaconference.com. We do take it seriously and we do look into it. And next, I want to cover RSAC Marketplace. This is our digital extension to our expo. We highly recommend you check it out. It's great. It's a great option for you to filter your products and solutions and plan out your expo tour. You also can use this year round to check out our sponsors and exhibitors. It's constantly being updated, so you'll always want to check in to see the latest and greatest. You can go to the website mentioned and explore the video and the exhibitors and sponsors that are in there. So we've made it through conference week. Everyone's had a successful trip. You've had successful meetings and you've learned tons of new information in your sessions. So what do you do after conference? The fun doesn't stop. We do send out an email after the conference with your session attendance report as well as your conference surveys. You're going to keep an eye out for this email because you will need that attendance report for your CE credits, as Casey mentioned. Your conference surveys will also be included in this, and we do highly recommend filling them out. Our team takes these very seriously, and we do review them extensively after the conference. We have had a lot of great new ideas and tweaks to the conference come from these. We really do value your feedback. So if you have a minute, please consider filling out the survey. On-demand sessions. If you missed a session or there's a session that you wanted to go back and rewatch, we will have our session videos and presentations posted. They're posted approximately 24 hours after the live occurrence. And top rated sessions. This is new this year and more to come, but it's open to full conference and digital pass holders. It's a curated collection of our highest rated sessions from RSAC 2022. We'll also include interactive follow-up sessions with speakers throughout the year. So keep an eye on your email and more information to come. And the last thing I want to cover is our RSAC 365 program. Like I said, the learning doesn't stop at the end of RSA Conference. So head over to our website and you'll see at the top navigation a tab for library. If you click into there, you'll see our 365 programs. It's a great way to access expert insights through our webcasts, our seminars, podcasts, blogs, and more. This is something that's run year round and our content team is constantly updating and working hard to keep this fresh. Also, if you're an expert and have insight and you're interested in contributing, you can check out the URL here. One other thing I want to point out is that we do have sponsorship packages for our 365 programs. So if you're interested in sponsoring and being a partner of RSA Conference throughout the year and not just the week of RSA Conference, please reach out to the sales team. We're more than happy to work with you.